gangster films from the 1900s to the 2000s. Little do you know, gangs has been around for a long time. Therefore, in the United States, gangs has been around as long as, you know, 1783, with the emergence on the East Coast as American Revolution. By 1860, gangs in the United States started to emerge more effectively due to the immigration from people in Europe, such as the Poles, Italians, Irish, and the Jews. By this time, America has been dramatized, yet accustomed to the street gangs that has been formed. So much violence going on, surprisingly, it made it to the big screen in Hollywood. What's ironic about this was people complained about the violence in their neighborhoods, but enjoy watching the same violence in the movies. This caused a chain reaction because each generation of gangs were exploited through the films. In 1912, the first real gangster film, D.W. Griffin, with the Musketeers of Pig Alley, which told a story of organized crime in the western part of America. Prior to this release, there were earlier films released as maybe like 1904 to 1906. They included The Moonshiners, Edward S. Porter's A Desperate Encounter Between Burglars and Police, and Wallace McCutcheon's documentary of Kidnapping the Black Hand. Hollywood gangster films really made a place on the map in late 1930s and 1940s. At this time, gangs were more corrupted in New York and Chicago. One of the most famous gangster films was 1932's, of course, we all know, Scarface. Paul Mooney, as Al Capone, played this lead. Howard Hughes directed this film while Howard Hawks also produced it. During the 1950s and the 1970s, the gangster movies started to change with the generation. As the economy and poverty got worse, so has the gangs and the violence produced in reality and on film. There were movies such as John Huston's The Asphalt Jungle in 1950, Stanley Kubrick's The Killing, Sam Peckinpah's The Gateway, and Don Siegel's Charlie Varrick. From the 1980s, 2000s, gangs in films has increased with more violence due to the different technology advancing over the years. There were also different concepts in the films also. For example, Sea of Love, Al Pacino played as an alcoholic cop. Jonathan Demme's Best Picture, The Silence of the Lambs, 1991, and Ridley Scott's Hannibal, 2001, which exploited cannibalistic behavior.